Periphyton are communities of algae and cyanobacteria that are found naturally on stream beds. It's an important part of the ecosystem. However, periphyton can form thick mats or long filaments that can make it unsuitable for stream animals, for swimming or fishing, or produce toxic compounds. Here is the equipment you'll need to measure levels of periphyton. The first step is setting up one or more cross sections directly across the stream to the next bank. You'll be measuring periphyton at 20 points along the stream, evenly spaced along these cross sections. Try to find a suitable spot for this. Don't sample in fast flowing water above knee height. A run habitat is the preferred habitat, but you can choose riffles or runs, or both, depending on what is the most common in your stream. For very small streams less than 2 metres wide, monitoring can be carried out in a zigzag path along the stream. For wider streams, set up 2 survey lines with 10 evenly spaced points, or 4 survey lines with 5 evenly spaced points. If some of your stream is too deep to wade across, you don't need to set up bank to bank. Stop when the stream gets too deep. Just make sure that the sampling points are evenly spaced and you have the same number on each cross section. There are 2 methods you can use to conduct the test. Which one you choose will depend on how much time and equipment you have. The first method is called the stone method. Collect a stone from each of the 20 points evenly spaced along your cross sections, starting downstream and moving upstream. Bend down to lightly touch the sediments of the stream bed without looking at what is there. Pick up the nearest stone to your foot that is more than 4 centimetres in diameter. Examine it carefully. Identify what you see using the periphyton identification images in the SHMAK manual. Record the percentage of the upper surface of the rock covered by each type of periphyton on your data sheet. Repeat this at the 20 sampling points. If you have a black disc viewer, you can look through the bottom window to estimate the percentage of periphyton at a site, not just on a single rock. This allows your estimates of percentage cover of periphyton to be more accurate. A bathyscope, which looks like an orange road cone, is even better as it gives a wider view. It can be bought from a marine shop. Working from the downstream end of your site, move out to the first point. Put the viewer down in front of you, about 5 to 10 centimetres underwater. Put your face tightly against the viewer. Record the percentage cover of the types of algae in your field of view to the nearest 5%. There are tips for this in your SHMAK manual. You may be tempted to put your viewer down in areas with lots of periphyton, but try to place the viewer down at evenly spaced points along your cross section without looking at the stream bed first.